fan can appreciate. It's a clean sheet of ice, and we are about to get underway. The quest for Lord Stanley's mug continues right here tonight, and we are underway. Stop by the goaltender.
Really good positioning as he makes the stop from in tight.
Lemieux's won a big draw on their own end. Quick feed to Lemieux. Here's a chance, a two-on-one.
Nice breakup by Lowe.
A great defensive play. Curry's going to play it against the half wall. Here's a chance on the doorstep. Beautiful.
What a save.
And keep them from lighting the lamp.
Sarasso
got loose in the slot, but the goaltender's equal to the task. That's a good save.
Swing and a miss with the stop.
Here comes back. Good save of his own. Yager blocked it, maybe.
Center's jammed up, and the winger grabs the puck. Feeds the puck over to Hall. Moves the puck along the half wall. Great heads-up play by the defender. Taken by Gonchar. And pokes the puck loose inside the offensive end.
Ice.
And the always popular icing call made, and you know what that means, Ray.
Now, offensive zone faceoff, man, he missed the play.
A slow start to game four here.
Gimme icing. Now they can't change. You've got tired guys on the ice.
And momentum on their side as they win the draw here inside the offensive zone. Coughs up possession of the puck. Smart heads up play.
Bad giveaway.
Pittsburgh's across the blue line.
They're back checking. It's just right on point.
Hall's taken down to the ice. We got a penalty coming up. There's the stoppage of play. Let's see what the
Gonchar
officials
gets called for the trip.
Gonchar's getting two for tripping.
They're going to be down a man here. Once he
it was all because of their back checking, which led to the quick transition.
A tripping penalty will result.
Tough to argue that call. Man advantage unit is set.
And if you're one of these power play guys, James, you can't wait now. It's your first opportunity of the night. You get out on the power play, you want to make a difference.
That was off the blocker. And that one's broken up. And now it's over to Francis.
Yager, look at this. Oh, good stop. He's had a quiet series. Hasn't really done much.
Takes the feed. Gets down in front of
him. Oh, look at that, Gretzky.
Well, they've been hoping that the
picking up the garbage. Big goal for the Oilers, open up the scoring in game four. The great one finds the back of the net.
Really effective power play there. They move the puck around and they're able to find a
block shot came right to him. And goalie's out of position. Reacting to that first shot. And then by the time he gets set, Gretzky's already put it by him. The Oilers captain comes through.
Edmonton's got the game's first goal. How much of a difference does that make?
Completely change your mindset, even with lots of time left. You can be more aggressive with the comfort that you have a 1-0 lead.
Slides the puck to McDavid. Slides it to McDavid. Oh, and a misfire as that goes right out of the zone. Blistering shot! Long jam in front, that's broken up. Curry's swooping in on the attack.
Gretzky's dangerous and he's got the puck now. He had the go-ahead goal earlier on.
Into the offensive end now. Here's a short pass to Barry.
Oh, look at that. Bob Airy.
And now their bench has a little more belief if they even know
the score. Unlikely source, Bob Airy comes down the wing and rips one by the blocker of Grant Fuhr. I think the Penguins have been shooting for that blocker. I think they find a bit of a weak spot there for Fuhr, but what a shot by the fourth line. Right in the slot here, but it must be those new sticks. What a shot. tying it up.
Inching closer to the midway mark of the period. We are all
that was a huge goal to get that first goal right back.
And now it's grabbed by Perfect. Throwing the neutral zone up along the wing.
And by number 77.
On the attack along the boards. Here's a chance right in front. Huge.
2-on-1 here. Anderson.
Come up with the puck. Anderson's got the puck. Here's a shot. And that goes off a player. What a great
and Recky, who has
pass.
Been on fire for the Penguins.
Puck lands back onto a stick.
Another one. Oh, the Penguins are going for that blocker. It's clear as day now. Recky comes in and snipes another one past through. Yeah, he doesn't react as well on the blocker. Penguins have found a weakness.
Pittsburgh's got the one goal lead here in the opening frame.
Better to be ahead than behind, and the coaches are telling them that they want more aggression. They want them to play more in the offensive zone.
Puck scooped up by Gonchar.
Another goal.
Puts it on goal.
I know, they're all going to be shooting their lots.
Takes the feed from the left side. And the puck leaves the zone going back to center ice. And that skips away on a nice defensive deflection. Great read to break up the play.
Hey, buddy, you got the lead. Play safe.
Sends it in deep. The Penguins will play the puck from behind the net. Sends the pass over.
New.
Along the half wall with the puck.
Hockey.
On target. Edmonton's got the puck.
Hit something in front.
Nice pass. Deflected away. Nice defensive use of the stick there. Takes the
Jagr.
Pass.
He's been quiet.
Moves it around along the half wall.
Jagr is still with the puck. Taken off by Klefbom nicely.
Klefbom's got it along the wing. Right up front.
Wow, look at that. What a goal.
Klefbom
picking Jagr's pocket and then putting it in the net.
He drops into the butterfly to try and take away his
great pass by
McStorley
too.
But the shooter's got enough time to find some room. He sees it and he doesn't miss.
Midway mark of the frame, it's all tied up. Stahl's one possession, moves it quickly over to Stahl. The Oilers take possession in the neutral zone. Handles the pass at center. That's a solid
hit. Huge hit.
Slides it up to Perry. Here's an odd man rush, right in the slot, and that shot goes nowhere.
The Oilers got to know I'm going for that blocker now. I wonder if they're gonna. Changes their end zone defense.
Here's a shot.
Oh, look at that. Klefbom, another one.
Bang, bang. Two goals and right around a
are you kidding me?
Wow, insane how quick that was. Bang, bang. Yeah, the defending team just couldn't.
This one goes off Barrasso's blocker. Barrasso and Fuhr are both right-handed catching goalies. Look at that shot. Roofs it. Wow, I don't think Barrasso was expecting that. The Oilers trying to take a page out of the Penguins book here. Look at that shot. Alright, so we're seeing some scoring here in the first period.
One goal lead, not to be Captain Obvious here, Ray, but this is what the coach wants to see, right?
Love playing in front of the game, and you want to make the opponent chase you around the ice. They've accomplished that with the
see, the Oilers making a little adjustment now. They're starting to lean towards that side of the ice. And they see a lefty shooting the puck.
Because
they know I'm going there.
So
let's see with the righty. Well, they give me a lot of space. Oh, but he doesn't have the same angle. Oh, Coffey. Snipes. The doctor. Another one, I think, to the blocker. Yeah. Fuhr screen there, no chance. What a shot by Koff to roof it from the blue line. shootout tonight.
Getting into the later stages of this period, you can feel the energy in this crowd. It's a tie game. Puck is play resumes. And forces a huge turnover here with the steal.
That was a stupid play by me. I should have went dunked it in instead of going to the middle. Gone. So I put him in a bad spot. Yeah, see, Gretzky's gone.
Never your fault. And it looked like there was some late moment lobbying there that didn't work.
Doesn't work.
No, none. Face off and another opportunity to take a look at the man advantage unit here.
If your power play's successful, you can really take the wind out of the other guy. You've been successful all right with the man advantage. Let's see if you can get another one.
Moosey to Coffee. And he slides it quickly to Draisaitl. Pokes it away here in the neutral zone. And now he angles it across to Crosby. And a great heads-up defensive play here. Moves it over to Coffey. And a stick in the lane ends that threat. Oh, what a beautiful glove save! And now he moves it to Lemieux.
Lemieux one-on-one here. Making a move. Oh, Lowe stays open. Nice play by Kevin Lowe.
Directed over to Draisaitl.
Good defense by Orpik.
Crosby's moving the puck through his own zone. And manages to clear the zone. Wholesale changes.
Oh man, that's a penalty. No. Huge hit by Yager. That looked like a charge. On Clefbaum. But he still got it.
Unleashes a cannon. Comes up with a stop.
Ah, Yager misses it.
Slides it quickly to Gretzky.
And the penalty kill here.
Passes it over to McDavid. Feeds the puck across to Gretzky. Here's the pass. Let's it go.
Oh wow, just missed.
You're going to go back and kick yourself for that one because he wants that on the net. He doesn't miss it by much.
And the goaltender covers things up. All sorts of frantic action in front of the net.
Yeah, everybody's scrambling around trying to help what's happening. Everybody's getting out of position. They needed
what's this
some help.
Hit? They're going to show it now.
That's going to rattle your
mind. Oh, that's another one. Who'd he get?
That is an enormous hit that he took.
Show.
In the final moments of this period, we got a tie game. Gretzky's won the faceoff deep inside the offensive zone. A chance right in front. Gives them nothing in front.
The shooter's right in the guts of the ice, but the goalie squares up, spreads out, and makes the save.
Back underway as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. The Oilers fire blanks on the power play. We're back to even strength here.
That's a long time to sit in the penalty box
to?
When the game is tied. And
oh,
you've just taken
hit.
A penalty.
Oh,
there's
going to be oh, a
penalty.
Right back
in
the box.
Officials blowing the play dead. We've got a penalty on the way here. Murphy's off.
That's
the
unfortunate.
Box. 2 minutes for tripping. Played with fire. He got burned, Ray.
He's digging around for the puck. And sometimes you just get caught. This time the player goes down and he's got to go to the box.
The power play unit goes right back.
It's been a long first period.
The frozen biscuits dropped and we are back underway here. And that's broken up.
Yager looking for his first. I won't give it to him.
Looks to get the puck over to Curry. Electric start to this one, unless you're a goalie, of course. 3-3 is where we sit after the first period.
Big contrast from game 3, this one a little bit more scoring. Early anyway. Penguins going for a pure blocker. Clefbaum having a great period himself.
Second period still to come. We'll take a quick pause and be right back with more action.
Yeah, he was so screened there. Oh, 6 shots, 3 goals, not bad. Time on attack, pretty even. My passing's not as good.
Welcome back, everyone. He's Ray, I'm James. Second period set to go. Pittsburgh's shorthanded unit gets off to a good start. They win the draw and take early possession. Now a quick pass to Curry. Sends it across. Quick shot. Puts it on.
Snuffed out.
Great hit the net, though, you got a better chance to score.
Gets it out of his own end. Tries to get this man advantage going from their own end now. From the right side and up the middle. Looking to make something happen along the boards. And now he moves it quickly to Coffey. Taken by Gonchar. Slides the puck over. Quick pass to Coffey. Oh, and they go back on offense. Oh, that's a clever move to make the stop. Quick feed to Coffey. And now he tries to get it across to McDavid. A chance on goal. Denies him on the
play. Crossing the net. Barrasso scanning his ground.
Things will slow down here for a moment.
Always a good play if you're not sure what's going on. Freeze the puck. I want to get another look at this one, James. This looks like it hurts. I'm glad I'm in a suit here.
And you running over Kevin Lowe.
Ray Ferraro with you here in the early going of this period. The next goal could be a big one as we are tied. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. And that's intercepted. Stopped by the goaltender. Still keeps
Messi
a hold of it.
Jesus
and a delayed penalty coming up as he got tripped up. Here's a short pass to Klefbom. Blocker save. And tries to make a diagonal pass to Klefbom.
Wow, look at that save.
Let's see what the call is. Just an old school trip.
Another
call.
Trip. You're killing me with these tripping calls. Messi is really fast forechecking. Taking the puck from Samuelsson. Now we got a 5-on-3 to kill. Edmonton's had like one every game, it feels like.
It's okay to be patient even if you don't score till after the 5-on-3 is over. Man, even a short one like this, can you have in the back of your head you could score twice.
And manages to clear the zone. Moves it quickly over to Klefbom. With the blast! And he comes up with a big time save on that from the blue line. Good hit to knock the puck loose. Sends it quickly to
Stahl. One guy out, Murphy.
Puck grab by Murphy. Hammers a shot, big time stop.
All right, let's try to kill off this 1:26 left on the power play. This Orpik. Coffey doesn't expect
man,
it. And boom. Crush.
Still plenty of time left in this frame. We are all tied up in this one. Puck is dropped and he wins the draw here in the defensive zone. Icing is the call here, and those winded bodies are going to be out there for an extended period here now.
Yeah, they can't get a change in, and so you go back, you kind of meander your way back as long as you can to kill time and get a little breath.
Good read by the winger as the two centers tie up. And that's broken up. Sends a pass over. Long reach breaks up the momentum. Great defensive play to break it up.
Got a fresh unit out. Okay, hopefully we can get some flow in this game now. I've killed like three straight penalties. The last like 6 minutes of the game.
Offense is on face off and he wins the draw. Oh, absolutely owns the crease tonight.
mark of the period. It's all tied up. Messier's won the draw deep in the defensive zone. Brings the puck into the offensive end now. He's got a step. Oh, what a chance.
Paul misses on that. He's not going to get many. Getting too aggressive here.
Now over to Letang. Stahl's picking up steam. Puck ducked in and the forwards will head off. Long lead pass into the neutral zone.
Oh, you gotta be kidding. Another trip, Shel Levecki, faggot. I deserve them, but still.
This was the penalty I think when I took, I was most angry at myself because you're not trying to do it, and then all of a sudden you see the guy go down and you're just
PK this whole game here.
There's the result. Another special teams opportunity for both sides.
Four in a row.
The man advantage unit is back to work again.
There hasn't been much success on this power play, but they get another opportunity, and you have to try and erase from your mind what's happened previously. Be aggressive, be confident.
And now it's over to McDavid. And he slides it quickly to Lowe.
I'm just going to be patient here.
Shot sails over the net.
Now he's got to get that on target. That's a scoring chance, and he doesn't even make the goaltender make a save.
Moves it to Gretzky.
Curry in front. Did he save that?
And now he moves it quickly to Curry.
Man, these guys are getting some looks. Unbelievable. Great pressure, but Barrasso standing ground. Straight power plays. I don't think they scored on one. They had a 5-on-3 as well. Not that they didn't have their chances, but Barrasso was playing good.
Moves the puck. Now a quick pass to Stahl. Great poke check on the reach. Here's a shot and a great save. Letang stick handling in his own zone. And he passes it up ahead to Malkin. Here's a blast. Makes the save. Edmonton's got the puck along the wall. Takes the feed. Moves the puck along the half wall. That's blocked. Takes it right in the chest. Looks to make a play over to Malkin. Quick feed to Kessel. Shot. Shuts him down.
Half of the goals in this league are scored from directly in front of the net. That doesn't happen with a save like this.
Shot denied by the
nice save again by Barrasso.
And now he moves it quickly to Coffey. Takes the feed. Move to the middle, and that one's broken up. Picks it up.
Oh, what a terrible pass by Orpik.
Centering pass. Knocked away.
Oh, I love the way they've played this shift. They've protected the puck well, but now they've got it. And they can run around the zone. The defenders can't chase them. They're too tired.
Can't connect. And it's a quick pass to Malkin. Here they are on the attack. Here he is shot right in front. Blocked in front. Here in the corner.
Everybody just tired.
I need to take another look at that. I thought there was room to get by. Clearly, I was wrong.
Toho McSorley gets knocked out. Surprised he didn't try to get up and fight.
Goings of the period. You can feel the energy in this crowd. It's a tie game. Puck scooped up by Murphy. Edmonton's looking to break out of their own end. From the right side, he goes to the middle of the neutral zone. Here's a shot. Big time stop there. Dreisaitl's got it against the boards. Takes the shot and makes the save. Again, the denial by the goaltender. Edmonton's got the puck. Slides the puck across to Messier. He almost lost it for a second there, but regains control of the puck. That's intercepted. Sends the pass over. Oh, boy. Here comes a three.
Oh, Jágr stopped by Fury. Nice save. Another nice grab.
Comes up with a stop.
Should have one-timed it.
There's the horn to end the period. This one living up to the hype so far through 40
minutes. All right, another
tied
pretty tight game type period, much like the series has been, except for game two. Both teams seem to have made some adjustments. Goaltending was amazing by Brasso there. I got outshot pretty bad. You look one for, they've had 8 minutes on the power play. I've had zero. So I still managed 12 shots, so I didn't get outshot too bad in that period, despite being down most of it. Alright, see if we can pick that blocker apart again.
Welcome back everyone, both teams lined up at center ice and we are ready to get this third period underway. Well, let's see what this third period can offer at what has been a score fest thus far. They've got the defense outnumbered, locks it down with a stop. I think he got a blocker on that one.
Really good save, control the rebound, get it into the corner where you can reestablish yourself.
Edmonton's got the puck inside the defensive zone. Quick feed down low. Here's a short pass to Lemieux. And play down to the ice.
I knew it. I can't even poke when I'm trailing because I'm going to trip him 100%.
Well, it's like you're in position, then you're
like the tripping penalty is like extra high this game. Curry.
They'll go back to work on their special teams.
Another power play, six of the game for the Oilers. Penguins still looking for their first.
Their previous attempts tonight. See if they have a short memory and can get something this time.
And manages to clear the zone. Taken by Dreisaitl. Puck knocked loose in neutral zone. Lifts the stick and takes the puck. It's a 2-on-1. Hall's got it in the offensive zone. From the point, they take control of it. Puts it in deep.
Dumping it in. Why would you dump it on the power play? That was an awkward play there.
And a big defensive play as they'll clear the zone on the penalty kill.
No mistake there. That puck had to go down the ice. It's down off the glass.
Gets it out of his own end. From their own end, trying to kickstart this power play.
I'm scared to poke check now.
Offside the call. Face-off just outside the blue line. Lots of time left in this period. We got a tie game. Puck is dropped and we are back underway. Strong use of the body to force the puck loose. Moves it quickly over to Crosby. Takes the puck behind the net. Right to the middle.
Oh, nice save.
Crosby
got open there. Orpik having a strong game. Oh, rings one off the crossbar. He's having a great game.
Everybody's looking around. We heard him hit the pipe, but off it goes up on a play.
Here's
Francis wins it in the offensive zone. Way to he scores! On the break, the tie here, James. This game has been hotly contested since it's been level. They now have found a way to jump into the lead. They're just trying to get out of this alive to keep the game tied. What a gift.
What a lucky break for the Penguins. Block shot. Ends up right on Francis's stick. Much like Gretzky's goal, and then the goalie's out of position. Shorthanded goal. The Edmonton power play is just killing them right now.
What's the message now for the stretch run, Ray?
To be aggressive. Too often teams sit back on their heels. They give up a chance. They give up a power play. Pretty soon it's an all-out scramble.
The Oilers get a hold of it. Coffey's going to play it against the half wall. Takes a shot. Too many bodies in the way. Moves it to Murphy. Stretch pass. Both teams back to even strength. And after giving up a shorthanded goal, it's an opportunity the power play unit would probably sooner forget.
Well, that doesn't go according to plan. The power play's done. And they've given up a shorty. Those are always deflating.
Edmonton's got the puck in their own end. Dreisaitl's got it in the corner. Takes a shot and makes the save.
I see.
Barry's moving it ahead. They've got numbers. Here's a shot. Stopped by the goaltender. Edmonton's got the puck along the boards. Over the line they come. Settles things down and gets control of it once again. They fight for it along the boards.
Good battle. Letang takes it from Dreisaitl.
Quick pass across
up to Bobry.
Clefbaum's got it in the defensive end.
Perfect. Another great stick. He's had an amazing game.
Edmonton's
on the defensive side.
The
Samuelson standing up.
Going
the defense. Look at his strong skier.
And he slides it quickly to Trocheck.
Nice pass, quick
right
pass
side.
To Reschy. Oh. Nice save. Fury was ready for that shot. He cannot allow another goal. The Oilers got to find a way to penetrate the Penguins' defense. They've really tightened up.
Play resumes here as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. And there's the save. Still lots of time left in the period. It's a one-goal game at this point. 4-3 is the score. Nugent Hopkins wins the faceoff. And he can't hang on after that hit. The Oilers trying to gain a step. He's in!
Great save.
Pittsburgh's looking to break out of their own end. Play whistle dead because of an offside.
Reached the halfway point of the third period.
Edmonton's failed to convert on scoring opportunities and lots of them here in this third period. This neutral zone faceoff set to go, and we are back underway. Quick pass to Kessel. Wrist shot from the slot. Big save as he gobbled that one up with the trapper.
Yeah, it's point in the game here. All the lines are a little tired. I'm going
to
have to be careful with my line changes.
Tonight, lots of offense. It's 4-3. Lemieux won the draw.
Oh, nice snap.
Fuhr's able to get out and make the save on that grade A chance.
Looking to make something happen in the offensive zone. And now he angles it across to Vukaboom.
Oilers having trouble getting to
the net
now.
And he slides it quickly to Murphy. Great positioning in the defensive end.
Edmonton's
coaches
have talked
here. Oh, what a block by Coffey.
There's a great example. They've done it all night.
And the Oilers' top shooter there. Really crazy.
Smart defensive play here in the open ice. Broken up at center. Gets the puck in deep. The Penguins gain possession along the wall. Tries to get it over to Crosby. Big hit. Puck picked up by Kessel. Here's a chance.
Stevens.
Three is the magic number.
That's going to ice it.
Three in a row here. nice play. Quick pass on the tape and into the net. So quickly the goalie can't get closed up and make the save. Pittsburgh's latest goal now gives them a two-goal lead here with just minutes remaining in this third. It's a good place to be as you get into the last half of the period, but you want to melt these minutes away by playing aggressively. Into the corner.
Oh, wow. Don't go home yet. Teakin' in. Huh. Just like that.
This drives coaches crazy. Everybody's staring
at him. Yeah, two guys went at him. Leaving Teakin' in wide open in front. He's a nice trimmer.
Edmonton's got one back here, Ray. How big is that?
Well, it does a lot, James. It changes your mindset. It changes the way you approach this. And you don't have to be reckless trying to get just one goal.
Puck picked up in the open ice. Pass across to Stahl. Here's an odd man rush. Lets the wrister fly. Turns it away.
So.
Edmonton's had more shots on goal, but yet they've run into a hot goalie. They trail late in this third period. The frozen biscuits dropped, and we are back underway here. Gets the puck over to Messier. On the attack along the boards. Here's a short pass to Berry. Here's a chance, and he elects to play the puck. Takes it across the blue line. Now a quick pass to Smith. And the shot dies in the traffic jam. Stopped by the goaltender.
Oh, ho. He's going to tie it up.
The Oilers can't believe they're back.
Oilers are coming on here.
Really good shot. Hits the goalpost, and they can't close the gap. Pittsburgh's got it from behind the net. Orpik's loving the puck.
Not aggressive.
Nice pass.
Recky.
Recky's got the puck. And he gets the puck right back. Snaps it on net, and the lane's clogged up blocking that. Moves it quickly over to Recky. Stick save for the goalie. Coming up on the final minute of regulation.
1 minute left.
And we've got a 2-on-1. Moves it to Clefbaum. Feeds the puck to Nugent Hopkins. Along the half wall with the puck.
Goalie's pulled.
Pass to Anderson. Misses. Trailing in this one, they have pulled the goalie and the extra attackers out. And it comes up with it.
I like this stop here. He makes the save, he looks in control, and the rebound's 30 to 40 feet away. They've totally controlled the puck here on this shift. Now they've worn the opposition down. Eventually, you get a score.
Jágr intercepts. He's got an empty net.
Fires to the empty net. And there it is. Empty netter. That'll seal it up. Pretty easy one right there for him to cash in.
Jágr getting his first of the Stanley Cup Finals into an empty net. He needed that goal. And the Penguins need that goal. They will be going up 3-1 in this series of all-time greats. Heading to Edmonton with a chance to win the Stanley Cup.
Pittsburgh's added to their lead with the empty net.
Penguins holding serve at home in both games. The only game they lost was an overtime game in game one, where Mario Lemieux got kicked out of the game. They didn't have him for like half the game. And this could be a sweep. Kessel. He's going to get a shot.
This up here. We're in the last little bit of the third period. That should be enough.
Two empty netters again from the Penguins. Gonna ice this game.
Just not a lot of results. McTaggart's won the draw here in the open ice. Great heads up play by the defender.
Coach throws his hands up. Turnover, turnover, turnover.
All right. Penguins one win away from the Stanley Cup.
Goes up 3-1.
heading back to Edmonton in a couple days for game 5. Yeah, the Oilers' power play just wrecked it for them. Barrasso made the big saves when he needed to. Stevens, I think that was a winner. Just laid it out in the third period. I wonder if the Oilers' top players got a little tired from all that power play time. I outshot them too. Huh. Look at the hits, 26. Definitely laid the body a lot more in this game. My passing wasn't as good, but won a lot more faceoffs too.